Hey friends, I hope that you all are doing well. I wanted to come on here and let you know that my second book, Ambrosia's Book of Spirits, the Liber Spiritus, is now available on Amazon. She's a thick girl. She's like 448 pages of my literal blood, sweat, and tears as a practicing witch. If you don't know me, I'm Jasmine, and I'm a practicing witch of a traditional American folkloric flavor. I lead the Solar Court Coven here in Indianapolis. And last year I published this book, sorry for the glare, which is Ambrosia's Book of Witch Flight. So you might be familiar with like the term astral travel. It's kind of like that, except I use the term witch flight because I feel like it gives it much more of a trad witch sort of flavor. Now, my first book that I published last year, this is not necessarily like a 101 beginner's guide to witch flight. This is a book with my experiences detailing the other world as I have seen it. The book was part of a pact that I had with a spirit at the time that was assigned to me via the witch's devil. And in this book, I share sort of mapping out the other world, the watchtowers, the castles, the realms, the spirits that I've encountered and that our coven has encountered. This book has recipes, prayers, rituals, but it's mostly a lot of UPG, unverified personal gnosis, and it's mostly a lot of shared personal gnosis with our working coven. In this book, there is a spirit codex that has 86 spirits, and I have sort of embarked on this project. Guys, it's so hot here. If I am a little bit glistening, it's sweat. I'm very hot and very over-caffeinated as well. But so in the Witch Flight book, there's a little bit about witch flight, some of my personal experiences in the other world, mapping out the other world, the spirit codex of 86 spirits, with a little bit of a glossary about them and their attributes, similar to other grimoire traditions like the Pseudomonachia Demonium, the Lesser Keys of Solomon, the Grimoire Verum. Okay, the girls that get it, get it. And then there's rituals, prayers, recipes. So I've embarked on this journey of extending the Spirit Codex. And this year I am coming out with two books, the first of which just dropped this month, which is the Book of Spirits. The other one will be an otherworldly book of sorcery, and that'll be the greater Liber Spiritus. This is the lesser, okay? Very demure, very mindful. Oh my God. Okay, so she's a thick girl. She's 448 pages. She has full color illustrations. Every single spirit in this also has a custom sigil as well as extended attributes. So things like elements, virtues, zodiac, location, royal arcana, fetch, demi-virtue, moon phase, planet, attributes, candle colors, suggested offerings, their known allies and enemies. And then you also get some gnosis for each spirit, along with Auntie Anka's tea time, who was my editor, who had a little bit of things to say about some of the spirits in this book as well. So it's a big book. And with that, it is also a little bit more expensive than the Witch Flight book. So I think that the Witch Flight book goes for around 20. And I think that right now with the sale, the Spirit Codex is going for like 38. But to give you a little bit of a size reference, hold on. I'm trying to like show you without the glare, but like this is the difference in the size. So the Book of Spirits is significantly larger. I also did this myself via Amazon's Kindle Direct Publishing. So this is self-published. And with that, Amazon also does have restrictions as well. So this cannot be published in hardback. It will only be available in paperback. I don't know if I'm going to come out with a digital version or not. So right now, this is it, the paperback version. I'm literally so hot, I'm fucking dying. But let me read you a little bit about the back of the book. Presenting to you the captivating Ambrosia's Book of Spirits, also known as the Lesser Liber Spiritus. This expanded codex is in continuation from Ambrosia's Book of Witch Flight. Within the pages of this enchanting tome, you will embark on a mesmerizing journey into the ethereal realm, where spirits dance and magic thrives, drawing from the unique wisdom of Ambrosia, that's me, This extraordinary book unveils the hidden depths of the spirits of the other world. Prepare to be spellbound as we reveal secrets and unveil the true power that lies within. Let the pages of the Lesser Liber Spiritus transport you to a realm where the boundaries between the earthly and the otherworldly dissolve, where the whispers of spirits guide you on a path of self-discovery and empowerment. And I will say that when it comes to witchcraft and sorcery, I've talked a little bit about this actually on my YouTube channel, Jasmine Ambrosia, check it out. But to me, pacting with spirits and working within the other world and witch flight or astral travel or hedge riding are all very like core aspects of my craft, my practice, and also of American traditional folkloric witchcraft. It is something that we witches have done. Now, this book is definitely not going to be for everyone, and that's also okay too. So just kind of keep that in mind. If you enjoyed the Witch Flight book, I think you're really going to enjoy the extended codex, the Book of Spirits. I might also allegedly be working on an oracle deck, maybe, we'll see. Right now I'm trying to get the greater out by the end of this year. The greater book is going to be a book all about otherworldly sorcery. So kind of following sort of the template of Solomon, where you have the testament, the lesser, and the greater. My testament is the Witch Flight book, and then I will have my lesser, which will be the Book of Spirits, that's out now, and then the greater, which will be a book of otherworldly rituals and really breaking down how to create otherworldly sigils that you see linked with the spirits in this book and how to make them for spirits that you come across using my individual system and the system that our coven uses. This book, I poured my heart into, okay? Like, we're talking long nights, very, very long nights. We're talking writing. We're talking being overly caffeinated. We're talking the use of entheogens. We're talking blood, sweat, soul, and tears. So I hope that you enjoy it. If you decide to get it, I would love to hear what you think of it. I would honestly love a review from you. And I hate doing this sort of like advertising self-promo thing, but unfortunately that's just like what we have to do. So, and reviews for indie authors or self-published authors on Goodreads or Amazon really go a long way. So make sure that you also review it there. And yeah, I think that's gonna be it. I think I've kind of rambled enough. So I hope that you all are well. And until next time, blessed be, and I will see you in the other world. Safe travels.